All right, apologies in advance. I'm not doing very well health-wise, and so I'm probably going to burn through quite a few reviews for the next few days of shows that I watched. Most of the shows were bad, but I wouldn't consider, maybe that's why I'm feeling so bad, but that's the way it is. This show is not. This is the Orville and their third episode. Continuing on with this, it's called New Horizons, and I guess this is what they mean. It's subtle, but there's, you know, it's no longer the comedy show. I mean, you know, you have your humorous characters in it, but that's it. And the slow pacing, I think, is still there, although in this one, it almost works. It's called the Mortality Paradox. So they received this detection of life on a planet that's supposed to be dead, and so they go to it, and there's a high school and everything. Well, right off the bat, you know, there's some sort of hallucination going on, that there's someone with psychic powers doing this to them, and that's what it is. And a lot of this is, once again, callbacks to Star Trek. It also involves, ultimately, you encounter a godlike being, if you will. Although this is a reference to an earlier episode, so it's connected to all this stuff, and it's all well and good. And some of the scenes are pretty interesting, how it plays out. The different scenarios they wander through in this seeming dreamscape, but the planet in reality is barren, you know. And apparently, I don't know how they would say it happened, because they do suffer injuries and everything, and that's just the impact of it and their reactions to it. But apparently, they were never in any serious danger. There is a little switcheroo out you realize, oh, one of them is not what they appear to be, and that sort of thing. There is a funny moment where they put them in a high school scenario, and they're supposed to have to deal with a bully. It's a giant monster. So yeah, there's still some humor in the show. Stuff like that. But oddly enough, it's one of these things, and this happens in a lot of the shows where they're put into some kind of dreamscape scenario, and so these were elements plucked from their minds, but I wouldn't have thought that, you know, the high school would look like a high school of today, you know, I mean, the high school that they went to. You know, there are some things, like you can go back to the original Star Trek, where they had Abraham Lincoln show up, and that was because, well, he was a personal hero of Kirk's, and so that's somewhat believable that this was a historical figure that inspired him or what have you, and so that's fine. But whenever you do something like this, well, you know, we wanted to shoot it in an actual high school, so you do, but you know it's too costly to make it look advanced or something from the future. So, you know, I guess we'd go with that. Then there's a scenario where they're on an airplane and all this type of stuff. It's all far removed from their actual experience. So, not that they wouldn't know about it. But to them, it's just history. You know, it's like looking at old cars that you never actually drove. You just know what they look like. So I kind of thought that was a misstep on that part. But, it was an interesting little journey for them, how they went through it all. I thought the ending kind of went flat, where the godlike lady shows up and explains it all. I don't know. And then it's just, ultimately, it counters on the reason they're doing it is because they're immortal and they don't, they're bored with their existence. So they lived vicariously through the Orville crew, where they kept running into these potential death scenarios, and they felt like they were in mortal danger, and that's what they were interested in. So, a really nasty, rotten thing. Even Mercer says, "Hey, what the hell?" and he's right, you know. And it's like, this is not good what you did. And they're like, yeah, come on. If you were immortal, you'd understand. Well, they're not. You know, we just want to fantasize what it's like to be mortal. They torture these people, you know. So, and then it ends on the philosophical discussion of why would you want to live forever and this sort of thing. And Mercer makes the point. This is like, well, I want to see what's coming, you know. Because, you know, if you die now, you miss out on what happens tomorrow and that sort of thing. Which, it's all well and good. Yeah, I think there's some flaws here in the show. Still better than current Star Trek. But that's, you know, you gotta just stop mentioning that because that's not really the point anymore. It's gotta be its own thing. And so, depends on where they're going. Don't know. But, I don't know, maybe the episode should be shorter for this type of material. I don't know. It, of course, is a legitimate sci-fi concepts and whatnot. They hit their plot points, and there is the, you know, some amount of mystery and things you didn't, maybe. I didn't quite catch on to some of the elements of it, but it was obvious after a point, it's like, well, when are they going to show this part isn't real and this is not what it is? And they lead you down. This is what it's really about. And you go, oh, no. And they, oh, no, it isn't. It's that kind of thing. And so they had some good twists in it. And that was all well and good. But, yeah, I think it the pacing needed to be sped up a bit. And maybe should have just stuck with. I think Mercer should have been even more angry than he was, because this wasn't something you just sort of laugh off what they were put through. Hey, we'll meet again. Yeah, no, we don't want to meet with you anymore. I think that would have been more impactful, because it's certainly true. He does. He's upset about it, but. You know, maybe a little more. But anyway, so there you go. Another episode of the Orville with the Mortality Paradox.